Alright, roll a class. Okay. So I mentioned in the last video, this is the last video that we need for this class, and so, of course, my iPad just happened to run out of memory in the middle, so it stopped recording. So I'd, just want to pick up where we left off. So I had to break this up into two videos. So let's review what we did. We're looking at this particular problem. We have a thin film of oil on the surface of water with air above. And so if we look at reflection off of the first surface, we have a phase change. We're going from air to oil, low index to high index, phase change. So you can draw like a dot there to remind you that there's a phase change. We're here from oil to water, no phase change. You can just leave that. Yeah, so, okay. So then to look at what happens to this ray as we follow it, through this whole process, what I'm now calling ray 2, we have to draw a somewhat more complicated diagram and work backwards. So again, we start out like this. Remember, there's no phase shift for a refraction, a refracted ray. Okay, and again, so if we want constructive interference, we have to end up like this because, we're comparing, this is like ray 1. Now I'm calling that ray 2. So that's ray 2. We want these to interfere constructively, so they have to look like this. And once we know what type of interference, we draw this part. We just have to figure out what to do in the middle. And you definitely want to look at whether or not there's a phase change at this reflection. If there isn't, you basically just ignore this line. Nothing's going to happen here. So again, we would just do that. Connectives. And we can see going from zero to maximum amplitude, that's a quarter of the wavelength. So for constructive interference, so this is a wavelength in the film. So by dividing by n, we can write as the wavelength in the vacuum divided by n. So that's what we get for constructive. And then for destructive, we want it to look like this. So this wave and this wave are completely out of phase. So to draw it, it would look like this. And so our condition for destructive interference then, going from zero to zero, remember this is surface A, that's B, and that's A. So from A to B, that's the thickness, that's equal now to, I'm going to draw it over here. That's also the thickness. So yeah, here we can see the thickness is 1/2 the wavelength, or the wavelength in vacuum divided by 2n. Okay. And I should point out that these are the minimum thicknesses that will give these types of interference. You can also have other thicknesses. Like if we just expand this, there'll be other thicknesses that will give us constructive and destructive interference. Usually we're just interested in the minimum thickness for each case, constructive and destructive. Okay, now again, these diagrams, this is just what I do. The book doesn't do this at all. I kind of like it because I like to look at things visually, but I should probably go about it the book's way as well. So let's look at the book's way, and ultimately what we're doing is we're comparing rays 1 and 2. And there's a phase difference between them, and for destructive interference, that net phase has to be half a wavelength, where for constructive interference, the net phase should be a full wavelength. So we're representing the phase in terms of distance instead of angles. But So let's look at both of these cases, constructive and destructive interference, just looking at phase shifts between these two rights. So there's always going to be, so in general, delta is always going to be 2t to start with. Because the difference between rays 1 and 2, well, ray 2 had to go through that extra distance of 2t. T is the thickness, it has to go there and back. And again, we're assuming white is going perpendicular. So like the little, it's a little more than 2t, but not enough for us to care about. So we'll say 2t. However, in this case, there's also a half of a wavelength phase shift due to the reflection at one of the surfaces. And so this would be delta between these two rays. So let's check, let's say we want destructive interference. For destructive interference, we have 2t plus half of a wavelength, and that equals half of a wavelength, which going to give us a t of 0. So for this one, okay, a thickness of 0 would technically solve this condition, but that's not anything useful. If the thickness was 0, we just wouldn't have this 2t term at all. So really, let's modify this a little bit. I don't have room to write it down, but for destructive interference, remember it's 1 half lambda, 3 halves lambda, 5 halves, and so on. So the 2t, that would mean that the film isn't there at all. So let's go back to the next condition that would give us something, which would be destructive interference would also occur at 3 halves lambda. And so this one we can work with. Let's solve for t. Right here, 2t. If we subtract half a wavelength here, we'd have 2t equals lambda. And again, we'll just say lambda is the wavelength in the film. So t would then be, this is for destructive. This would be, if we convert that to the wavelength in vacuum, we'd have lambda naught over 2n, which is exactly what we had here. Now let's look at constructive interference. We have 2t plus 1 half lambda. That would have to equal constructive interference lambda. So if we solve for that, we have 2t equals lambda over 2, or t is lambda over 4. Or lambda naught over 4n. So just by looking at delta in terms of the path length difference plus that phase shift that we have. So you have to take that into account. Now, I don't like this approach as much because I can't see what's going on. But if you like doing it this way, that's fine as well. Okay. So we looked at one particular case where we're going from air to, we're always going to go from air and then to a film over some other medium. But here we're going from a high index of refraction to a low index of refraction. So I want to change that around. Let's look at another example where we go, I'm going to erase the whole board. So then I'll do another example where we go from like a lower index to a higher index. So let's do that. So yeah, I'll just start over entirely. So let's say we have this situation here. Let's say we have air. And then water. And plastic. Or glass or something. Yeah, let's go with glass. Pretty sure glass is 1.5 or approximately. Okay. And so now if we draw this, we've got our first reflection where, as always, there's a phase shift here because we're going from air to something else. So it's always going to be low to high in that first case if you're going from air to something. And then the next one, from water to glass. So these are the two we're comparing. Water to glass, that's also low to high, so we're going to have a phase shift here as well. So what we're going to do, again, last time we had two pictures. I want to actually combine them into a single picture just because it's more compact. So it's kind of like before, where we have, A, B, and A. This is surface A, this is surface B, that's ray 1, and that's ray 2. And so ray 1 is going to look like this. Again, now there's a big gap here. So before, ray 1 just looked like this. It's just bouncing off surface A. And so it's the same picture, except we just expanded it so we could show all the stuff in the middle. But again, this electric field doesn't, it's reflected. It just goes, it never enters this region. So basically, it's just this picture. We put it up here. And now, let's look at constructive interference first. Remember, refraction, nothing's going on there. And if we want constructive interference, again, now we're comparing these two electric fields. These two are in phase if we draw it that way. So now what we have to do is figure out how to draw the middle so that that we can get this picture. And now we have a phase shift in the middle, so we have to draw it in a way that once we get to the boundary, we flip it upside down. So let me just draw it first. So if it was going to continue, it would look like this. But because of the phase shift, it's going to flip upside down. And that's going to give us what we need. And so again, going from 0 to 0, this is half of a wavelength. I don't want to write it down. Well, let's just say for constructive interference in this case, we have half a wavelength in the film. So this would be lambda naught over 2n for constructive interference. Now for destructive interference, I think I'll just erase this and redraw it. So for destructive interference, we want to end up like this, because these two are clearly out of phase. So again, we have to remember, no phase shift in the middle, so it enters like that without anything happening. But now we want to find the minimum thickness so we can connect it like this, with a phase shift in the middle. So again, I'll just draw it, and it looks like this. So if it were going to continue here, it would look like that, but because we're flipping it upside down, it's going to look like that. Now, it might bother you. Oh, wait, this should not be a dashed line. That should. There. Now, it might bother you that this electric field is discontinuous. It flips from here to here. You can picture it's like it's interacting with the molecules at the boundary. And so you can picture it just like a steep line. Not a discontinuous jump. But anyways, this is a picture for destructive interference. And this is a quarter of a wavelength. So I'm just going to jump right to the end. We'll convert that to the wavelength in a vacuum. So we have, for destructive interference, lambda naught over 4n. So again, you can either do the equations or the picture, whichever way you like. When doing these problems, definitely want to show your work. Okay, and that's thin film interference. And we've only looked at finding like the minimum thickness that will give us the results we're looking for. I think I'll save it for the in-class review. We can look at another case with a thicker, we'll find like the other thicknesses that will give us whatever type of interference we're looking for. But actually, I think there's a suggested problem. So yeah, maybe I'll just do that during class. Okay, so that'll be it now. Yeah, I guess I should do one more thing though. And let's do it the book way, looking at constructive. Yeah, we started with constructive, so. Constructive interference. Now, actually, let's look at delta first. So it's always 2t. There's always going to be a phase shift of 2t because, you know, one of the rays went through that extra distance. And in this case, that's all we have. What about the phase shifts? They both went through a phase shift of equal amounts, and so those effects cancel out completely. And so that's it for delta. So let's look at destructive interference. So for destructive interference, we'd have delta 2t equals lambda over 2. And so t would be lambda over 4, or lambda naught over 4n, which is what we got from the picture as well. Constructive, we'd have 2t equals lambda. And so for constructive, we'd have lambda over 2, or lambda naught over 2n, which is exactly what we got here. So yeah, you can do it either way. This way it looks quicker, but again, I mean, it was a lot quicker doing it this way, but I was kind of explaining the graph as I was going along. Again, if you practice this and know how to draw these pictures, again, this process is very quick. You just, you can draw these pictures pretty quickly. Again, whichever way you like, I just really like to be able to see what's going on, like see the electric field. So I prefer doing it this way, but you can do it whatever way you like. But again, show your work so I know how you got your answer. Okay, and then that'll be it for the class. So other than the review during actual class time, that'll be it then.